Good to see you all on today's broadcast. This is the program, My Testimony. I'm happy you are here again to hear my testimony. I appreciate you all for your subscriptions. I appreciate you all for the likes, for all the comments. I'm having a wonderful time reading through your comments. And I appreciate you all. I'm glad that this program is a blessing to you. And I want to plead with you to continue to share this program, share this video to friends, to everyone. Let them see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Let them know that God is always with them in whatever they are going through, and that the love of God is spread abroad in our hearts. He's a faithful God, and he will keep doing what he has done before, because he never fails, he never changes. Hallelujah. He's not a partial God. What he did to one, he can do for another. All you need to do is follow the same process, which is the word of God. When you follow the same process that other person followed, you receive your own miracle, just the same way that other person received the miracle, because God is faithful to all. Hallelujah. Glory to Jesus. So my last video, I talked about my first love, the story of my first love. Please, if you haven't seen it, check it out. And I really appreciate that. You can write me your comments. Tell me what you think about the video. I will definitely reply you. I'll be glad to do that. Glory. Hallelujah. All right, today I want to talk based on matters arising from that last video. I want to talk based on that. I know one of my big fans, I love you so much, Ma. Thank you for following me on this program. She said, I hope the next video is going to be on how I met my husband. Oh, I wish so too. But like I answered that, that's still very far off. It's still very far off, but if you are patient with me on this channel, I assure you that you'll get to hear that very soon by the grace of God. Now, I want to tell you that after that, you know, I told you my first love story was when I was 23, and I told God that I wanted to marry at the age of 23. And do you know that 10 years after that, I was still single? Yes. 10 years after that, I was still single. Yet, I judged God faithful. Yes, I judged God faithful because he's faithful and he's a rewarder of those who diligently seek him. Yes, he has proved that to me, and I can assure you that that is who God is, a rewarder of those who diligently seek him. If you serve him with all your heart, you seek him, you will surely find him, and you'll find him with rewards. Hallelujah. He'll be waiting with rewards for you. That's what God did for me, and I know he can do it for somebody. Now, I tried to raise some issues from that because, when God gives us a promise, when God gives us a promise, most of us expect it to happen like tomorrow, like immediately, like right now. The problem and the challenge that believers, Christians have, most Christians have, is that they don't have the patience to wait. To wait for God to come through for them. They're always in a hurry. They want to see it right now. So God said, you're going to be this and you want it right now. I want to know that there is a time for everything under the sun. That's what Ecclesiastes told us. And that word is true. God does not work by our time. God works by his time. Yes, we may give God a time, but don't give him that time without saying, nevertheless, not my will, but yours be done. Jesus gave us an example of that when he was praying for the cup to pass over him, the cross of this redemption plan that God had for man. When he was praying and saying, God, let this cup pass over me. He did not stop there. He said, nevertheless, not my will, but yours be done. I think believers need to learn, Christians need to learn how to say, thy will be done, and mean it from their hearts. Yes, we need to learn how to say, thy will be done, oh God, and then mean it from our hearts. Because severally we say, Lord, let thy will be done, but in our hearts what we mean is that our will be done. But do you know that your will may be very good, but God's will is the best. Is the best for you. You may not know that because you think you have planned it all out. This is how you want it to be. Yes, that's how I planned my own life out too. God, at 23, I want to marry. You see, I'm keeping myself. I'm obeying you. I'm serving you. At 23, I want to be married. So I've just settled down, blah, 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 and all that. But God has something better for us. Every time our own way fails, it's always because God has something better for us. But for us to achieve that something better that God has for us, we need to be patient. Yes, with patience. I like what Hebrews chapter 6 verse 12 says, that it is with patience that everyone that has ever received a promise from God, it is with patience that they obtained that promise. Check it out. Father Abraham, Sarah, when God promised them a child, did we not hear at what age they finally got that child? At 99, 98. That was after about 25 years of waiting. God wants us to wait. Patience is a virtue. A virtue that God has, and a virtue that God wants us his children to have. It is with patience that God is, you know, carrying all of us as people on earth. Look at it by yourself. What is happening all over the earth? If God is not patient with us, we would have all along been consumed. But God is so patient, and he wants us, his children, to have that virtue of patience too. Now, whenever we suffer delay, we suffer some things, it's because God wants to build up that virtue of patience in us. Because that virtue of patience in us will take us places later. Hallelujah. So I think God wanted to build patience in me, and I think God succeeded at that. Yes, God succeeded at that, because the more than 10 years that I waited after the very year that I wanted to marry, the more than 10 years that I still had to wait before I finally got married, God used it to build a lot of things in me and to build patience in me. I was not angry with God. At the moment I suffered that first heartbreak, when everything failed, yes, I felt bad, I suffered, but the Lord helped me because I left it in his hands. Glory. Glory to Jesus. So whenever we leave things in the hands of God like that, it comes through for us. So whatever you're going through, you have to learn to leave it in his hands. Your age doesn't matter. The reason why so many of us go into the wrong relationship as believers is because we think about our age. We think about our mates. God will not give you your husband just because you want to compete with your mates. Just because all your mates are married, so you want to marry. God will not give you, you know, husband based on your prayers that, Father, all my mates are married, I want to marry. No. God will not give you your husband or your wife based on all my mates are having children. Very soon I will hit menopause and I'll not be able to have children. God will not give you a husband or your marital destiny fulfillment by that single reason. Why? Because it's the God that does not need menopause to give you children. It's the God that does not need your age to give you a husband. It's the God that does not need your age to settle you down in marriage. So when you cry to God in the name of, my age is running out, my age is running out to marry, girl, calm down. God does not need that. That is not going to work. You need to allow God's will to work through your will. You know, Bible said there's a perfect will of God, perfect will of God. Most of the time we rush and we take the submissive will of God. Anything that comes, we take. But the perfect will of God is what will give you peace and give you an expected end. His thoughts towards you are of good to bring you to an expected end. But if you are not patient, you end up, you know, taking the wrong thing. You end up helping yourself. God wants us to be patient with him. If you have ever obtained any promise, every child of God has a promise from God. The promise comes in your relationship, in your intimacy with God. If you are not intimate enough to hear from God what he has to say to you concerning your destiny, concerning your next level, concerning what he wants you to be or wants you to do in life, if you are not intimate enough to hear him direct, then you can bank on his word, the word of God that you know in you, the word of God that you have read, the promises of God. The word of God is a book of promises. You can take those promises, but through patience and through faith. Yes, that is what Hebrews 6 verse 12 says, faith and patience. So it's we don't need to be walking by sight, walking by our age. My age is running out. Everyone in my family is getting married. Oh, even my younger brothers are getting married before me. My younger brother got married before me. But when my time came, I still got married. You understand? So you don't need to look at those physical things. Those physical things, things that are happening around you, that is walking by sight and not by faith. When God gives you a promise, he wants you to obtain that promise by faith and through patience. You have to be patient. You have to be patient. So all these years of waiting to finally get married, to finally meet God's perfect will for me, God's perfect plan for me, what was I doing? I was serving the Lord and I was serving him with gladness. I wasn't worrying about it. A time even came, I did not pray about it. To tell you the truth, I did not pray about my marriage. It was even after like 10 years of waiting, I now realized that this thing is getting too long. I really need to start praying again and asking God what's going on. You understand what I'm saying? And it wasn't with grudges, it wasn't with anger. I was ready to take whatever God was ready to give to me. Now let me tell you something that happened to me also in the line of that first relationship. You know, I told you how it all started. If you have not seen it, if you want to understand what I'm talking about, you can go to the video and check the story of my first love. Hallelujah. My first love story. That's the title of the last video of my testimony. Now, I told you how it all happened. So I didn't really seek the face of God as to, is this it? I just went ahead with that, you know, like I said in the other video. So I attended a conference shortly after the engagement and before the marriage, you know. I attended a conference and I had a song. Somebody did a song, a special number, "Thy Will Be Done. Oh Lord, teach me from my heart to say Thy will be done. Thy will be done. Thy will be done. Lord, oh Lord, teach me from my heart to say, yes, Thy will be done." Because several of us will say, "God, I want your will." It is not from our hearts. In our hearts, we're actually presenting our will to God. Most of us, when we bring our relationship before God, we are presenting it with, "God, I'm already in love with this person. No, this is the person I want to marry. This is the person I want to go out with." So we don't want to hear what God wants to say about it. And even when God is talking, we don't want to hear it. We are just saying that God should approve this one for us because we have already gone far. We're already into it. We're already in love. And we don't want to hear of heartbreak. We don't want to hear. And that thing you don't want to hear of is what finally happens in the end. So you must pray, "Father, teach me from my heart to say Thy will be done," because it has to come from your heart. If you want God to help you, it has to come from your heart. If you say, "God, Thy will be done," that Thy will be done that you're saying must be from your heart, because God searches your heart. He knows what's in your heart. So even if your mouth is saying Thy will be done, God is saying in your heart that, "God, don't take this one away. Just approve this one for me. I'm already in love with this." Then He's not going to do anything. He's going to leave you to yourself. You know, then by the time you go and then something go wrong, you come back to Him. That is what God does for us, because He said, "My spirit will not strive with man again." No, He's not going to strive with you. He's going to allow you to do what you want to do. But in the end, when you start suffering the repercussion, you will not say, "God, where are you? He will tell you, "I am where you left me. I never left. I have always been there. You were the one that walked away." Praise God. Hallelujah. So we must learn to say it from our heart and mean it from our heart. "Father, let Thy will be done in my life. Even if I struggle to take that which is not mine, even if I'm at the last point of getting it and it's not your will for me, Father, take it away from me. Take me away from it." I prayed that prayer that very day in that conference. Yes, I prayed that prayer. I realized that in this relationship, I've not actually even told God that His will should be done. I've just accepted it based on what I told God long ago, that by 23, I want to marry. And then this is it, you know. And I've not really prayed to search His will out. So that day, I broke down in tears and I prayed that song sincerely from my heart. "Father, let Thy will be done in my life. Even if I struggle to take that which is not mine." I even said that even in marriage, even if I'm at the verge of marrying a man that is not my husband, a man that will not give me the kind of marital destiny that you want me to enjoy, "Father, no matter how I struggle for it, take it from me. No matter how it hurts me, take it from me. Let Thy will be done." I prayed it. It wasn't an easy prayer to pray because I was already in love. I was already deep gone in it. You understand what I'm saying? So no matter how deep you have gone in that relationship, if God is not in it, it's not going to work. You better suffer the hurts now than to suffer it later. You know what they say? That a broken relationship is better than a broken marriage. So it's better you don't go in, and when you go in and then you want to suffer. When you go in, you have to work it out. You will suffer, you're going to go through bruises, but you have to work it out, because God does not like it when you break your marital vows. So if you're already in a so-called mistake marriage, this is not time for you to break out. It's time for you to seek the face of the Lord on the patience that you need, on the faith that you need, on all that you need to do to work it out and to make that home work. But if you have not made that mistake, please don't make the mistake. Hold on to God. God never fails. Yes, He may tarry, but He will never delay. The Bible says, though the vision is holding for a while, it will speak, it will not lie, it will not lack. So it's just, let His time come. When His time comes, He will make all things beautiful in His time, not in your time. No, we forget that timing has to be the timing of God, not our timing. The timing of God is not always our timing. But if we listen carefully, we will hear God telling us his timing for us. So we'll be able to wait patiently for that time. If you want to obtain the promise of God that maketh rich and has no sorrow to it, then you must walk by faith and not by sight. And then you must be patient to obtain that promise. You must be patient to get to that promised land. You must walk with God patiently. It may take time, but delay is not denying. God will come through for you if you walk with him patiently. God needs us to be patient. This world is full of troubles because so many of us are so impatient. We want to take it and want to take it now. So if God is not moving, we move him by force, or we move something else to make it work for us. Then God will just be looking at it, because it comes with thorns, it comes with sorrows, it comes with many troubles. So as you have taken it, get ready to take the troubles that go with it. If you don't want the troubles that go with it, then leave it for the Lord and let him work it out for you and make all things beautiful for you in his time. So tell me your age. And you think it's too late for you to get married and to enjoy marriage? Go back and read the testimony of Mother Sarah. In her patience, she obtained the promise. Go back and read the testimony of Anna. In her serving the Lord, in her putting God first, she got a promise. Go back and see the testimony of Elizabeth. Even when she thought it was gone, she had even forgotten. She had, look at the husband Zechariah. Even that, he had given up on it. He was like, no, don't excite me. Don't worry, I'm not even interested in that anymore. And then the angel got angry with him and made him dumb. Praise God. So, it's better you leave yourself in the hand of God like that. That's what I did. I served God to the point that somebody even one day told me, you know, when I was doing this youth executive thing in my church, and then we had one program that we had to do youth camp and all that, and we had a leaflet for signing. I took it to her excitedly, and then she said, "You are still doing this youth thing inside the church, not outside. Inside the church, not outside the church. You are still doing this youth thing. Won't you go and marry?" That was what a Christian sister told me. "Won't you go and marry? Don't you know that you are old enough to marry now? You are still doing this youth thing," just because she married before me. And that would have been a knock on my head. That would have been, what do they call it? That would have been something that would just, you know, deflate the balloon of excitement with which I was moving. But I knew what God told me, and I exactly told her, "Don't worry. When my time comes, I will marry. But for now that I'm a youth, let me enjoy my youthful age. Please sign for me." I said it both, and I not go home to worry about it. I laughed over it, and that was how I saw it. Why? Because I knew what God told me, and I knew that this God I'm serving can never fail me. I did not backslide because of what happened to me. No. I did not backslide. So those of you that are backsliding just because you have not obtained the promise that God promised you, you are getting it wrong. You need to wait patiently for the Lord. If you really want to get it, then be patient. It's not time to backslide. It's not time to cry. It's not time to say God has failed. God does not fail. Even if you backslide, it does not change him from being God. You will do yourself good to stay put and to build up faith in this God that never fails. You will do yourself good to check out the testimonies of others, of how he never fails. And then you wait patiently for him to do it for you, instead of you taking it by force or going to get what he has not given to you. Glory to Jesus. Please hear this today. God is faithful, but he needs your patience. He needs your faith, not your tears, not your conditions, not your threats, but your faith and your patience for him to come through for you in every promise that he has made unto you. And he will come through for you in Jesus' name. Thank you for watching this broadcast today. Please subscribe if you have not subscribed to this channel. The next video, I'll be telling you what happened after that first love story. And then, if you subscribe, you'll be the first to know about it. And then you hear the whole story of how I finally got married. Thank you all for all your comments. Please keep it rolling in. I'm sure to answer you. Until I see you again in my next video, keep having a wonderful walk with God and keep experiencing awesome testimonies in your walk with God. Share this video to everyone again. Let the world know that God is too faithful to fail. And let the world know that what God needs from us is just patience and then faith in our walk with him for us to be able to obtain that promise. If you read the book of Hebrews 6 also, you will understand what I'm talking about. Please go and read it. Until I see you again, enjoy awesome testimonies in your walk with God. Ciao.